And the first experience I had that with that was King Midas in reverse.
So Graham had written King Midas in reverse, and he said, well, let me just put it down on acoustic first. So the basic track is just acoustic, right? And then I put just a drum beat to it, and then we built it from there, just a basic drum beat. And later on, we did the trick, we speeded the track up, and then we put some tom-toms on, and then put the track down to its normal speed, and then the tom-toms sound like boom, 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 like timpani, but they're just ordinary drums. And we just wanted, you know, kids in the sweet shop again wanted to do that. But later on, we added the... John Scott did the wonderful flute arrangement, you know, the overall arrangement, and the little march out at the end. It's a diddle-da-da-diddle-da-da-da. Very, very lovely stuff.
If you could only see me, I know exactly where I am. Be me. Oh, I can assure you that I'm not the guy to run with, 'cause I'll throw you off the line. I'll break you and destroy you, given time.
Nobody wanted to know the Hollies for King Midas. They wanted the Hollies for doing the stuff that we'd done previous. So, you know, you can't really blame anybody. We more or less, I suppose, trained the public into liking us for what we'd done with the pop songs.